Okay. Well, every engraving starts with a design. And this particular horse was designed by Yoshi Harkuba, an engraver and friend of mine, who designed this horse for Steuben originally, and I've engraved it several times on different vessels. I'm going to re-engrave this horse again. And as you can see, this was the original design. We enlarged it for this glass, which was blown by Bill Gutenrod, the advisor here at the studio. And what I did, I made a paper tracing and drew this horse again, exactly like that, only a little larger. And then I coat the back of the tracing with plasticine, rub that in, and rub it in really well on the paper. And then I place this on the glass, wherever I would like to have it or where the designer decides to have it. And I tape that on, locate it exactly where I want it. And then I take a stylus, a steel point like this, and I trace every line of the tracing back onto the glass. So this gives me a very thin white line on the glass. And when I take the tracing off, I will have a white line going on this whole background on the glass. So after I have that all traced on, I go through the whole scene here. And I take this tracing paper off. I will show you how the line shows up on the glass. So I won't finish this whole thing because I'll have another one ready here to go, but I will show you how this line shows up on the glass. I don't know if you can see it through the camera. I can give you a little more of a darker background here. And then I take a pen, India ink, and I redraw all these lines that I just traced through the paper. And I redraw all these lines here. As you can see, I do this whole thing again. And once I have it all traced on and the whole thing is completed, then I will take a piece of shellac or a brush and shellac and shellac this horse with, as you can see, the coating on this to hold the lines on the glass. Once I have that done, I start engraving just the smaller, larger areas that are on the drawing, and start engraving those into the glass. And with that, I use a copper wheel and abrasive. This is like either aluminum oxide, and I mix that with mineral spirits applied to the wheel, and they start engraving the larger areas on the design. as you can see, I'm taking the bigger masses that are on the design and making this those into bigger forms and just leaving them gray. When I have those all established, then I will do the lines that the artist has foreseen just to be in line on the outline of the horse. So I'll do the larger sections first. Now, in some areas where the forms are larger, I use a larger wheel. And as you can see, where the forms are larger, the larger wheel covers a much bigger area, and it's much quicker to engrave that given area. So I've pretty much covered the larger areas now with this wheel, and now I want to go and refine some of the outlines on these larger areas with a smaller wheel to get it right to the edge of the design. So I go a little smaller wheel now. So now I have the larger forms pretty well established. I want to cut in the hoofs now. And for that I have a wheel that's more shaped, has a sharper edge on it, so I can cut in the front part of the hoofs and slide them up into the fetlocks there on the horse. Okay, so now I have the hoofs established, and I'll take a smaller wheel now to make the outlines like Yershi has designed on that horse. And what I do with this little wheel, I'll just skim the outlines. I don't really cut it deeply into the glass like you would with a fine line. I just skip over the glass to establish a line. As you can see, I'm constantly applying abrasive to the wheel. The wheel itself really just only gives me the shape. It doesn't do any cutting. The cutting is only done with the abrasive that I apply to the wheel. All right, so on this one here, I'm very close to finishing that part of the lines. As you can see, the outlines are established and the forms inside the horse are established. So now I'm just touching up the areas that are not connected and cleaning up some of the lines. Yeah, when Yershi designed his horse, he wanted to do it in the most minimal way of expressing it with very little engraving time involved to develop this horse. He just wanted it kind of sketchy, and most of his work was sketchy. Even if they were portraits of people, it was just a feeling of the form of the image that he had. So when he explained this to me, he says, I want you to interpret my design into your technique. And I mean, there's many ways to engrave this horse. You could have engraved it three-dimensionally all the way through, take the whole body out and engrave that and put the muscles inside. But the way he engraved it, he wanted just the main shapes of the horse showing. And when you look at the drawings, there's really only a couple of forms in the head, a couple of forms in the neck, and a few forms in the belly, and then the hoofs, and that's about it. And it's just a few lines for the legs and the tail. And that's the way he wanted it. So the finished horse then looks like this piece here that I did with a single horse on it of his design. And as you can see it, image done of drawing, and this is just the basic forms that I put on this glass. So that's how the whole thing is built up. As you can see, I've started with every image, every part of the engraving there is, with the tracing, with drawing it on the glass, shellacking it to keep it on the glass, starting in the forms, then refining the forms and finishing the lines, and then the finished horse on the glass. And this is a single glass that I engraved with just the one horse on it, so you can see how I interpreted his drawing to my engraving. Okay. Start it off for. Yeah, keep on working and just, yeah, okay, I can do that, yeah, sure. Thank you. Yeah, we're coming pretty much to the end. So this is what I redid all the lines on this horse here. This is so almost like the finished one, which is here. You can see this one here is totally finished with the lines and the forms in the horse.